सर रिजल्ट कब आएगा?
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
अभी थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा। हेलो
जी सर,
अभी थोड़ा सा रिजल्ट में आपको टाइम लगेगा।
ओके सर।
So today topic is mode of transmission of the parasites. As the name of topic indicate, the how the parasite is transmitted from one host to another host. Means every parasite has infective stage which is transmitted from one host to another host through different mode of transmission and cause disease in their definitive host. These are the different mode of transmission of the parasite or its infective stages and cow disease in their host. One of the most common route of transmission of the parasite is ingestion. Ingestion of different stages of the parasite, larva or egg of the parasite through the contamination food and water. Then transmembrane transmission through the feeding of the colostrum or milk. And parasitic stages transmitted to their offspring through the mother. Then a skin penetration, parasitic stages penetrate the definitive host and penetrate the skin and enter the inside the body of the definitive host. Then another mode of transmission, inoculation occurs through the arthropod vectors and various parasite amoeba stages transmitted from one host to another host, and also a direct contact mode of transmission also found in parasite, and some of the parasite mostly arthropods are transmitted from one host to another host. Another transmission is venereal transmission to the coitus from the infected bull to cow. And then another mode of transmission is congenital transmission, or another name is intrauterine transmission, prenatal transmission, or transplacental transmission. Through the fetus get the infection through the mother, and then auto infection, infected parasite get repeatedly infected with the dear host. Then inhalation, some of the parasite or its stages also transmitted to their host through the inhalation of their infective stages. So these are the mode of transmission of the various parasite or its stages from one definitive host to another definitive host. Then one by one we discuss, and some example we also see. Then first mode of transmission is ingestion, means through the ingestion. So final host get parasitic infection through the ingestion of infective stage of the parasite through the contaminated feed and water. Infective stage contaminated feed and water, and ingestion is most commonly occur through the mouth, and ingestion or mouth is the most common route through the parasite enter inside the host. Mouth or through the ingestion, parasite is enter inside the host. This is the one of the most common route of a mode of transmission of the parasite. As for example, this is the Fasciolite hepatica example. This is the Giardia example. So first example is Fasciola hepatica. I have told Fasciola hepatica is commonly known as liver fluke. It is fluke, so it is a trematodal parasite. And definitive host of Fasciola hepatica, it is sheep, goat, cattle. So final from the Fasciola hepatica located inside the bile duct of liver of the definitive host. And adult flukes lay the eggs. Eggs are excreted through the feces of the infective host, and eggs develop into Miracidium larva. Miracidium larva is enter inside the snails. A snail act as an intermediate host. Inside the snail, Miracidium larva develop into a sporocyst larva, then radial larva, then Sarcaria larva. So sporocyst, radial, Sarcaria larva are formed inside the intermediate host, that is the snails, and Sarcaria have tails and emerges from the snails and insist form the cyst by the attachment of the gracid and form the metasarcaria. Metasarcaria is the cystic stage of the larva to protect from unfavorable environmental condition. And final host, that is cattle buffalo, is get infection by the ingestion of grasses or aquatic grasses through the ingestion of metasarcaria infected grasses. And metasarcaria is enter inside the gastrointestinal tract, then metasarcaria, outer wall, cyst wall rupture, and immature flukes emerged out. Their immature fluke penetrate the gastrointestinal tract and through the blood circulation enter the liver and finally bile duct. So, Fasciola hepatica get infection through the ingestion of metasarcaria larva infected, metasarcaria cyst infected aquatic grass. So this is the ingestion, through the ingestion Fasciola hepatica transmitted from one host to another host. Then another example of ingestion mode of transmission of parasite is Giardia. Giardia is a zoonotic protozoan parasite, means man, dog is commonly affected with the Giardia. So Giardia is a zoonotic parasite, means transmissible from man to animal or vice versa, that is animal to man. So Giardia is a zoonotic parasite. Giardia is a protozoal parasite. Its final host is man dog and is located in the gastrointestinal tract of man and dog, and through the feces of the infected host, Giardia cyst is secreted out. This is the trophozoan stage of Giardia and this is the cystic stage of Giardia. Generally, cystic stage found in the feces of the infected host and then scattered out in the environment and contaminate the feed and water. And final host get infection through the ingestion of contaminated feed and water. Giardia cyst contaminated feed and water. Then life cycle continue. So Giardia infection occurs in man and dog through the cystic stage infected contaminated feed and water. Kyunki generally sewage water में generally cystic stage रहता है, उसके drinking contaminated drinking water के पीने से Giardia amoebic dysentery, that is intermediate distillate का cyst enter करता है mouth के gastrointestinal tract में. Then another example of ingestion mode of transmission of parasite is commonly Tinea solium. Tenia solium is a cystoid parasite that is tapeworm. Its final host is man and intermediate host is pig, because in pig muscle larval stage of Tenia solium, that is Cysticercus cellulosi, develop, and larval stage of cystoid is known as metacystoid. Larval stage is cystoid, any cystoid is known as metacystoid or bladder worm. So always keep in mind, larval stage of cystoid is known as metacystoid or bladder worm. There are different type of metacystoid. Tenia solium metacystoid is known as, that is larval stage is known as Cysticercus cellulosi, found in the muscles of the pig. So final host get infection, that is man get infection through the ingestion of raw or uncooked mealy pork. Mealy pork means improperly cooked pork, that is pig meat. Because inside the muscles of pig, Cysticercus cellulosi larva found, and improperly, that is mealy pork, eating of the improperly or mealy pork food, meat, might get the infection of Tenia solium. This is the ingestion mode of transmission of the parasite. Another common mode of transmission of a parasite ingestion by the ingestion of the intermediate host. Intermediate host, because inside the body of the intermediate host, infective stage of parasite are developed and found. So, example of the ingestion of the definitive host, intermediate host, that is Diphyllobothrium latum, is also a cystoidal parasite commonly known as fish tapeworm, because this second intermediate host is this. It located in man and dog of intestine, adult Diphyllobothrium latum found in the intestine, small intestine of man and dog. So man and dog act as a definitive host or final host. Through the feces of the man and dog, egg of Diphyllobothrium latum is created on the environment. Egg develops into larval stage, that is Coracidium. Coracidium is the first intermediate host, that is Cyclops. And in the Cyclope, first larval stage, that is Metacystoporus acquired, develop. Then fish eat the, or ingest the Metacystoporus acquired ingested Cyclope, and inside the fish, Procerpid develop into Plerocerpid larval stage, and Plerocerpid is the infective stage for the Diphyllobothrium latum. Plerocerpid is the infective stage for the Diphyllobothrium latum, which found inside the body of the fish, and final host man dog get infection by the Plerocerpid infected raw or uncooked fish. So Diphyllobothrium latum infection occurs in definitive host by the ingestion of Plerocerpid larva infected fish. So mode of transmission of the parasite by the ingestion of the intermediate host, because inside the intermediate host, infective stage of the larva, infective stage of the parasite develop in some of the parasite. So this is the all example, above example, I have discussed how the ingestion mode of transmission of the parasite, Fasciola infection. First, I have discussed Fasciola hepatica infection occurs in final host through the ingestion of the Metacercaria infected aquatic vegetation. Second mode of transmission, second example of ingestion of the Ingestion of the infective stage is the GRDR. Infection occurs in man and dog through the ingestion of cyst contaminated feed and water. Third, I have discussed here is the Tinea solium. Infection occurs in man is the definitive host and pig act as an intermediate host for Tinea solium. So by the ingestion of the mealybug pod, that is cysticercal cellulose infected, or that is pig meat के खाने से Tinea solium का infection man में होता है. Fourth example I have discussed under the ingestion mode of transmission is Diphyllobothrium lighter. Diphyllobothrium lighter definitive host is man and dog, and two intermediate hosts required for the complete their life cycle. First intermediate host is cyclops, and second intermediate host is pig. Fish. So infective stage develop inside the muscles of the is that infective stage is pleurisulfide larva, and man and dog get infection by the ingestion of the pleurisulfide infected fish. Then second mode of transmission of the parasite is transmembrane transmission means offsprings get infection from their mother through the ingestion of the colostrum or milk. Means infective stage definitive host ke body mein rehta hai. After pregnancy, after pasteurization, infective stage of the parasite is secreted out through the colostrum of the milk of the mothers, and offsprings, pups or cup get the infection through the ingestion of the colostrum of milk contaminated infective stage. Example of the transmembrane transmission is the Toxoparacanis. Toxoparacanis is the Ascaris, that is nematode roundworm of the dog. This is the different mode of transmission of the Toxoparacanis. One of the mode of transmission of the Toxoparacanis is transmembrane transmission. Means Toxoparacanis definitive host is dog. Inside the small intestine of dog, adult Toxoparacanis found. Toxoparacanis eggs excreted out through the feces of the dog in environment. Egg develop into third stage larva. and final host may get infection by the ingestion of the third stage larva, which is the infective stage for Toxoparacanis. So first mode of transmission is ingestion of infective third stage larva. Second, third stage larva is enter inside the paratenic host, means no development of third stage larva for Toxo inside the paratenic host, and dog get infection by the ingestion of third stage larva infected paratenic host, that is reptile and rotund. चूहो के में यदि third stage larva Toxoparacanis के है तो उसके ingestion से भी transmission Toxoparacanis का होता है. Third mode of transmission that is discussed here is transmembrane transmission. Toxoparacanis larval stage found in the muscles of beaches remain as a dormant stage, dormant in the muscles of beaches. Then beaches are pregnant, and after the pasteurization, larval mobilized and excreted out through the colostrum or milk of the beaches, and pups get infection through the ingestion of the larval contaminated colostrum or milk. This is the mode of transmission of transmembrane transmission in case of Toxoparacanis. Another example of transmembrane transmission is Ankylostoma caninum. This is also a nematode commonly known as hookworm Ankylostoma tinnitus is commonly known as hookworm of dog. Ankylostoma tinnitus is also transmitted through the transmammary transmitter from the bitches to their pups through the larval contaminated colostrum or milk. There is different mode of transmission. One of the mode of transmission of Ankylostoma tinnitus is transmammary through the ingestion. Mode of transmission is also occurs in Ankylostoma tinnitus. So transmammary transmission occurs in case of Toxopara canis Ankylostoma tinnitus. For the transmission of infective stage of the parasite from one host to another host. Then third mode of transmission of parasite is a skin penetration, that is percutaneous transmission. Means through the skin penetration, Ankylostoma tinnitus is transmitted through the ingestion, transmembrane, and third mode of transmission is a skin penetration. Means Ankylostoma tinnitus found in the small intestine of dog from the feces of dog. Egg of Ankylostoma tinnitus is created out in the environment. Egg develops into third stage larva. Third stage larva is the infective stage for Ankylostoma tinnitus. Then third stage larva is enter, especially in children during playing with the dogs or playing in the soil. Third stage larva enter inside the body of the children or inside the body of the host, in the body of the dog, through the skin penetration of the third stage larva. Means third stage larva dog और चिल्ड्रेन के बॉडी में स्किन को पेनिट्रेट करके स्किन को छेद करते हुए थ्रू द ब्लड सर्कुलेशन पहुंच जाता है, डिफरेंट माइग्रेट करके फिर वो स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन में एडल्ट Ankylostoma tinnitus डेवलप करता है. तो स्किन पेनिट्रेशन दैट इज परक्यूटेनियस मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन फाउंड इन केस ऑफ Ankylostoma tinnitus. And another example of under a skin penetration, that is percutaneous mode of transmission, is Schistosoma. Schistosoma is commonly known as blood fluke. Blood fluke, that is trematodal parasite, is found in the vein of the infected definitive host. क्योंकि यह डेफिनेटिव होस्ट Schistosoma डेफिनेटिव होस्ट के वेन में रहता है एडल्ट फ्लूक, इसीलिए इसको ब्लड फ्लूक बोला जाता है. तो Schistosoma का ट्रांसमिशन स्किन पेनिट्रेशन के द्वारा होता है क्योंकि इसका डेफिनेटिव होस्ट इज कैटल बुफैलो सीप गोट एंड from the infected definitive host, egg of the Schistosoma is created out in the environment. Egg develops into Miracidium larva. Miracidium larva enter in the snails because a snail is always intermediate host for the trematodal parasite. कोई भी trematodal parasite का intermediate host a snail होता है क्योंकि डायजेनेटिक ट्रिमेटोडल पैरासाइट का इनडायरेक्ट लाइफ साइकिल होता है. इंटरमीडिएट होस्ट रिक्वायर्ड होता है फॉर द लाइफ साइकिल को कंप्लीट करने. तो फ्रॉम द इनसाइड द लार्वल स्टेज डेवलप इनसाइड द स्नेल्स एंड फ्रॉम द स्नेल्स सर्केलिया इमर्जेस फ्रॉम द स्नेल्स एंड स्विम इन द वाटर and the final host get in contact with the Sarkaria. Sarkaria penetrate the skin of the host and enter in the body of the definitive host. So Sarkaria Schistosoma infection occurs in definitive host through the penetration of the Sarkaria larval stage. Then fourth mode of transmission of parasite is inoculation, is occur through the arthropod, that is blood sucking arthropods. Thymus parasite requires Iger vector for the transmission of the parasite, arthropod vector for the transmission of the parasite, like Trypanosoma cinerea. I have discussed in previous class, vector of the different parasite, Trypanosoma cinerea, vector is Leishmania, Leishmania is also important for parasite, vector is Phlebotomus fly, common name of Phlebotomus is sand fly, and Babesia species is a protozoan parasite, and vector is tick. Plasmodium is also a protozoan parasite, vector is mosquito. So all these parasites transmitted from one host to another host through the this vector get the infective stage of the parasite during the blood sucking, and further blood sucking of another host, then inoculate the definitive host, and that host get the infection of the parasite. So Trypanosoma fly, one host the Trypanosoma fly ko suck karke another host mein inoculate kar deta hai during blood sucking. Trypanosoma fly act as a mechanical vector. Mechanical vector means Trypanosoma cinerea ka koi bhi development iske andar nahi hota. Leishmania, Babesia, Plasmodium, mosquito ticks act as a biological vector for these species. This is the Babesia. Babesia is an important hemoprotozoan parasite called red water disease in cattle. It is transmitted through the tick. It act as a vector inside the tick. Different stages of Babesia develop. An infective stage of tick ascorozoite inoculated through the blood sucking of the infected host. Then another is Leishmania. Vector is sandfly, that is Phlebotomus. Man, dog act as a definitive host, so get infection by the inoculation of the promastigote infective stage by the sandfly during the blood sucking. This is the promastigote stage and amastigote. Amastigote stage commonly develop in definitive host, and promastigote stage is developed in sandfly, that is infective stage for the Leishmania, which is inoculated during the blood sucking. This is the direct mode of transmission. Physically contact with two hosts, parasite transmitted from one host to another. Most common parasite transmitted through the directly mites, lice, flea. Mites is located beneath the skin, lice located on the body of the surface, flea is a temporary parasite, all are arthropods. Is transmitted from the one host to another during the physical contact with the infected host. Demodexkinis is important type of mite commonly found in dogs. Pups get infection during the contact with their mothers. Then this is the lice. Lice infection commonly occurs in winter season, which is transmitted from one host to another host through the physical contact with the lice infected host. Then venereal mode of transmission occurs through the coitus, means during copulation various parasite transmitted from one host to another host. One of the common example of venereal mode of transmission is Trypanosoma equipartum. Trypanosoma equipartum commonly found in case of horse and cow disease Dorine, so it is transmitted from one host to another host through the coitus. During the coitus, so coitus mode of transmission found in the Trypanosoma equipartum. Another example of venereal transmission is Trypanosomiasis foetus. This is the protozoan parasite and commonly found in case of cattle and cows early abortion. 9 months ke pregnancy generally before the early ever 8 to 16 weeks after pregnancy abortion cause karta hai Trypanosomiasis foetus protozoan parasite found in reproductive tract of the cattle. So it is transmitted from one host to another host through from infected bull to cow. during the quarters and cause absorption in the infected cattle. So it is a malarial mode of transmission. Then auto infection mode of transmission, various parasite repeatedly infected means during auto infection due to reverse peristaltic movement of the intestine. One of the most common example of auto infection is Tinea solium. Tinea solium पहला तो होता है कि बिजली पॉर को खाने से सिस्टी सर्कस सेलुलोसिस कंटेनिंग बिजली पॉर को खाने से थ्रू द इंजेक्शन मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन. अनदर मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन मींस इनसाइड द डेफिनेटिव होस्ट माय एडल्ट टीनिया सोलियम फाउंड इन द इंटेस्टाइन एग ले इन द इंटेस्टाइन एग does not excreted out through the feces of the man. Due to reverse peristaltic movement, eggs through the upward movement develop into larval stage. Larva hatches, oncospore, and through the blood circulation enter in the brain and eye of the man and cause then enter inside the brain. During the auto infections, Tinea solium larval stage called neurocystocercosis. One of the most common cause of epilepsy in man means feet turner. This is the Tinea solium auto infection means Tinea solium का एक definitive host के फीसे से बाहर ना निकाल के reverse peristaltic movement is time के द्वारा एक ऊपर की ओर आ जाता है इंटेस्टाइन में. एग्स डेवलप इनटू लार्वा, लार्वा म्यूकोसा को पेनिट्रेट करते हुए फिर वो ब्रेन में आ जाता है या एआई में चला जाता है. ब्रेन में जाने से माइंड में होता है जो लिएंडर पेस्ट को भी हुआ था ड्यू टू ऑटो इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द टीनिया सोलियम. अनदर मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ द पैरासाइट इज इनहेलेशन. इनहेलेशन के द्वारा भी some parasite are transmitted from one host to another host. One of the one important protozoan parasite is cryptosporidium, transmitted through the inhalation of the oocystic stage. Thick wall oocyst again, two type of oocyst form in case of cryptosporidium: thin wall oocyst and thick wall. Thick wall oocyst enter inside the body of host through the ingestion or inhalation, and thin wall oocyst enter inside the body which does not excreted out through the infective through the feces of the host. They cause auto infections and form the infective stage as sporozoite. So both auto infection, inhalation and ingestion mode of transmission found in case of Cryptosporidia species. This is the all about of different mode of transmission of the parasite: ingestion, transmembrane transmission, inoculation method, venereal transmission, then transplacental transmission, then inhalation transmission, then direct contact transmission. These are the different mode of transmission of the parasite. You always remember with the example of different mode of transmission of the parasite. This is the general part of the transmission of the parasite. But most common mode of transmission of the parasite is